Fellas, welcome back. Today we have 6 pre-release packs. We're starting off real quick with the Eustace Captain Kid. This one is the promo you get for participating. We also did get our special promotion pack, right? Which includes 2 cards, a common and an uncommon. We have Gizmonda and Keep Out, both with the pre-release stamp. I don't think these are cards that get used a lot, but hey, we'll take any that we can get. But then let's move on into the packs. Here for the pre-release, the guy in front of me had told me the story of how in a previous one that he went to, he had actually seen someone that got all leader packs, which means you get nothing special. And we were hoping that that was not gonna be our luck. So we're starting to look at some of the cards. And as we go through, we find that we do have a leader. We have Rob Lucci, meaning that our first pack, a dud. Luffy and Kaku there for the rares, nothing special. Going into the second pack, I think we were hoping to just pull a secret rare or a super rare actually. You could see at the top that the guy in front of us had the boa. He had pulled some heat off the bat. We have Weevil, Raiju, Edison, Marigold, Keep Out again, Kueiza, Spandam, Itomitsu, Karibu, and another leader, damn. Foxy and 2 rares. The most fun part, I think, out of these pre-release events is that these 6 packs are completely random. You don't know what point of the box they're in. You don't know what you're getting. Opening that pack was a bit rough. I think I bent the card in the back. You're about to see. It's a bit of a special one. But ultimately, we have a couple more. Not so many repeats. Overall, not very good cards as well for the pre-release. But then, Vegapunk! A 3rd leader pack. Can you believe that? But there it is. We have the Dawn. You can see at the top right corner, it is kind of bent a little bit. But we were cursed. We were cursed to see that there was nothing for us. And could this continue into the 4th pack? So now we're in our 4th pack, just praying. Those hands are getting sweaty, knees weak, mom spaghetti. Oh, a little something maybe? I think I had already seen it. And look at those shaky hands. Just kind of going through some of the cards, pretending like we're not gonna get a good hit. The guy in front of me already laughing. No, just kidding, he was a good guy. And then at the end, we do have an Onami special rare. Look at my hands shaking, can barely keep the card in focus. I honestly could not believe it. A special rare card within the set. I think this is one of the most beautiful cards. Definitely one of those Nami collection cards that you need. The lanterns have that sort of foiling effect going around it. Insane looking card. Putting it there, a bit of the awkward angle just because I didn't have enough space in the table. So we're kind of gonna work with that. And moving into our 5th pack, hoping for something. I think around this time, I got a little bit slower just because someone 2 people away from me had actually pulled the manga rare boa. Kinda jealous. But we'll see. A couple more cards. Maha, Snake Dance, Keep Out, Pickles, Koribu, Luffy, Hattori, Atlas. Oh, what's that in the back? Traffic or Law? The guy immediately wanted to check it out. He could not believe our luck. From 3 leaders to a special rare and then alternate art Law, insane. Shaky ass cards. Our guy here asking if we're gonna keep that Nami. Hell yeah, we are. And still cannot keep a steady hand. Can you believe that? We're gonna put that out of focus for some reason. Gotta bring that Law back. Shine it a little bit more for the camera. Honestly, some of the best foiling I've seen. Probably one of the best alternate arts from this set. Okay, and then for our last pack, can we hope for a 3 hitter? Out of 6 packs, that would be insane. Okay, let's see what we've had though. Starting off with Papag, Moria, Apu, Buckin, Chopper, Sedereshe, Zoro, Joseph, and another leader. So that's 4 leaders and 2 alternate arts. Insane luck for the pre-release. Honestly, had a great time, was not able to get too far. It was a 64-person event. We managed to get into the 3rd one, the 3rd round, but we had won our first, lost the next 2, and at that point we were out of prizing range, so had to drop out. I'll leave you guys here with a little bit more of a show, a little bit more up close on both the Onami and the Law. But if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure to subscribe, hit that like, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!